I have this friend Paula, and she lives in Arusha, Tanzania. And she started an organization called Wangaza. Wangaza is the connection between the disabled and the medical services they desperately need.
People out there, they really don't know that there is a help, and others, they have a problem with thinking about the theories of causational diseases. So many people kind of shy away from hospital because either they believe they are bewitched, or they believe this does not need an operation, or it cannot be done. So it's important to have people going out there, try to explain to them and assure them and that this can be done, something can be done and to improve their life. And this has really helped many people. It has really helped many people.
It starts with a long drive. Over a week's time, Paula, her partner Amiri, and anyone else who wants to tag along, travel to the most remote villages and homes outside of Arusha. It is where the Maasai and Barbai tribes have dwelled for 600 years. It is also where the disabled have been neglected nearly as long.
People do not abandon them and do not neglect them, but it's because they don't know what to do. I think this is the main problem.
Paula calls these journeys outreach safaris. Their purpose is to organize a clinic. With the help of local friends and village leaders, the word gets out and the patients come.
In the village, we announced it in the church or to the mobile clinic of child and mother's care. And also we use the primary school teachers to send the children home, just to give the announcement to their parents. Gradually they come.
In the rain season, you can find them near, because they are not going far away from the service, things like a hospital or primary schools. But in the dry season, they are moving far away to find the grasses for them. They are kettles.
For the first time in their life, they are directed to a hospital or program that can provide them with the necessary medical care. For the first time in their life, they are given hope. It is not long before the patients are under care in the form of surgery, interim care, and rehabilitation.
He's really well connected, actually.
But Wangaza is not only changing the way an ancient culture thinks about disabilities. It is promoting good health along the way. from education in the primary schools to building safer water sources to prevent diseases such as fluorosis, a disease caused by high levels of fluoride, which discolors the teeth and cripples the bones.
We are just trying to teach them what is our idea, and we put that water tank to show them this was our idea. After that, the students, primary school students, they can take the idea from the primary school to their villages and to teach their parents what they learned from us and what we did in the primary school.
Wangaza is a lean organization where the largest donations come from its own volunteers, and fundraisers are organized by their friends and their family members. Where the only luxuries are perhaps replacement parts for the truck or some time with the locals. Wangaza is not a large organization, but one that believes that good comes in small packages too.
Understand, it's not easy for people to go into the bush and work there. So I think she's quite a kind of one of the few people who are willing to go out in the bush and stay there.
What can be offered is the explanation to show you how you get out of your disability condition to be more or less the same as other people, to be independent. And after repairing, the child can eat himself, the child can talk properly. I think that's a wonderful help.
I have this friend, Paula. And she lives in Arusha, Tanzania. And she started an organization called Wangaza for simple reasons.